Johnny Storm. That was Better by Guns N' Roses. And the interview with Hell Came Home, Damian Reed. So another good one for the record books. Another good show. Another good interview. Thank you. Thank you very much. So speaking of Guns N' Roses, they played at the Troubadour, or however the fuck you say it, in Los Angeles. They did like a $10 gig. The fucking place was packed with famous motherfuckers. I don't understand what's going on, but I guess they're bringing AC/DC shit up again, and Axl, and they pulled the fucking April Fool's thing with Sebastian Bach going to be the replacement. Sebastian Bach's on tour, so I don't know how you really could fool people knowing the guy is booked on his own tour. Okay. People are that dumb. But most people that are following all of these artists know already, you know, this guy's going on tour, Guns N' Roses. Who knows? I guess they're going to resurrect fucking Kurt Cobain to fucking do the vocals next. Who the hell knows? Maybe they'll bring fucking Jimi Hendrix back from the fucking dead. The shit is so stupid. It really is. Just find someone to fucking do the shows. And forget the drama. It's all for fucking press, and it's working. Guns N' Roses, apparently, from another fucking source that I can't say even trust at this point either, but that they're going to be the opening band, and that was part of the photo shoot. And it's just, you know, how when bands go out on tour together, they take a picture for promotion for, like, Rolling Stone and shit together. But whatever. Who cares? I don't think Axl's going to put $100 million fucking tour on the line to fucking front fucking AC/DC for fucking $3,800 a night. I don't know what it is, but I'm sure. But now that Hell Came Home is the first show of April, hopefully we'll get some good numbers there. They're definitely going to get them on Granite Coast. But April 12th next week is Mokradon. So we're going to have those guys on. Then Isolated Antagonist is the 19th, Born in Exile, and Map the Universe on the 26th. So Map the Universe will be in the second half of the show because, you know, they're like two separate bands. I can't have them both on at the same time. So I'm trying not to run the interviews too long because it gets drained out, you know. You've heard some of the stories already, so I got to try to break it up and do unique things. But, you know, what can you do? But I'm looking forward to doing the vinyl show and the fucking cold cock whiskey drinking show. But I want to play you a little clip of Guns N' Roses live the other night. So here's a little bit of Welcome to the Jungle. So it sounds good. All the bitches on Blabbermouth for fucking however many years since 1993 wanted these fucking guys to get back together. They all cried for years for them to get back together. Skid Row get back together. Blah, blah, blah. Now they're getting back together and all the fucking same fucking assholes are on the site going, Axl's fat, Slash looks like shit. It's a cash grab. You are the motherfuckers that wanted this shit to happen that made it happen now anyway. You're the first one to bitch. No one wants a Walmart to open in their fucking neighborhood, but those people who fucking protested, the first motherfuckers in there on fucking Black Friday trying to get a fucking Game Boy for $10. People get on my fucking nerves. I have some brand new Tiger Tales to play. I know I listen to everything from 80s, 90s. So it's always a mix on the show. But these guys just sent me a digital promo copy of the CD. So I'm going to play those. But listen to some more fucking Welcome to the Jungle. And not Blabbermouth, bitches. Judge for yourself, because this is on a fucking cell phone, this recording. We'll be right back. Benin. Frank is a good drummer, and that's why he's still playing with Guns N' Roses. But they sound good. I don't think Axl's fucking Sam Crow haircut and whatnot, but whatever. Let's see what else we got here. Let's see how this shit sounds right here. You never know what you're going to get, so I got to be careful how I play this shit. It's more fucking Welcome to the fucking Bunghole. Let's see what we got on this one. Some of these I'm listening to for the first time as well. This one I'm listening to for the first time. His voice sounds great. They sound good. The tickets are reasonably priced, I guess. So, I mean, you're going to be able to go to a show. I mean, if you want to fucking schmelt on Axel Schwein, then you might have to pay a little more, but whatever. I think it sounds good. Axel's got more fucking outfits than goddamn Madonna. But overall, it's going to be... Here's another thing that I want to fucking get off my fucking list of shit to talk about real quick. Okay. So fucking Sebastian Bach is going to play at the House of Blues on May 2nd. This is no means a plug for the show, but you know what, I'm gonna talk about it anyway so he can have the fucking plug, because there's like fucking 19 people probably listening right now live anyway. All the listens come down the road, so this is for all of you live listeners, recorded, whatever. How the fuck do you sell a ticket for $20 and have a $10 service fee on it? How is that not fucking regulated? I know Pearl Jam and this one and that all fought Ticketmaster, but Jesus Christ, man. If a ticket's fucking $20, 10%, okay, so give me a $2 service fee. 50% of the ticket cost for... you just sold two less tickets to a show because it pisses me off. I understand I buy a fucking $78 ticket or a $200 ticket or a $325 ticket to get a $10 service fee. Not on a fucking $10 fucking a $20 show that I already got to drive a fucking hour and a half to and fucking probably pay parking and all and food and all of this shit. But it's the principle. It's that it's 50% of the ticket cost, and it's fucking ridiculous. It's fucking stupid. I don't think it's right that they should be able to get $10 off a show that's only 20. So Adam from the band Mongrel made a good point, which I was looking to do anyway. But with that band being in Orlando, that show being in Orlando, I got to find the fucking band that's selling tickets locally so I can buy it from them less the service fees, which is probably a better idea anyway, because those bands, you know, it's a pain in the balls to sell a ticket. So I'll probably look for it that way just to prove a fucking point. But that, I don't know. I don't know if it was because I had an asshole waitress at Bob Evans that started it off, and then my insurance company called and they fucking bring back fucking shit that fucking aggravates the hell out of me. So it reminded me of fucking tragedy or... But whatever. So I was already in a bad enough mood. And then I go, oh, let me look for the Sebastian Bach tickets. And you got to have that. But whatever. Judas Priest is coming out with a new album sometime in early 2017. So those guys are still at it. Bands are giving big fuck yous to the music industry. Nothing new. It's just for fucking attention. There's video. Let's see what we got here. Let's pull up some Sebastian Bach now and see if it's even worth the fucking $23 to go. Let's check it out real quick. You listen to the J Stone Show. Go ahead, let's go. live at rockmetaltalk.com. Here's some Sebastian Bach. Typical showboating with his hi. I definitely want to see him. It's this fucking goddamn service fee that's pissing me off. Listen to it. Sounds fucking great. Again, off a fucking cell phone. So, I don't know. I think fucking Skid Row should take the motherfucker back, but you know what? One day they're going to want to do that, and he's going to give them the old big fuck you. So here's Bloodsuckers by the Tiger Tails. I'm Jay Stone. You'll listen to my show live from Tarpon Springs, Florida, at rockmetaltalk.com.